Did you know you have more bacteria in your gut microbiome than human cells in your body? Also, I just read that there's more bacteria in our gut than stars in the Milky Way. I'm Val, I'm a registered dietitian nutritionist. Today we're gonna be talking about the gut microbiome in general, so how we can heal our gut microbiome because it plays such a huge role in our digestion, in our mental health, in our stress levels, and in our overall cancer prevention. All foods and all nutrition filters through our gut, so it also plays a huge role in our absorption of our food and our nutrients. So if you're dealing with bloating, if you're dealing with indigestion, if you feel like nothing makes you feel good, you eat foods and you feel sluggish, that's a sign that we might need some help to make our body and our system function better. So we have so much bacteria in our body, and some of our bacteria is really healthy for us, and some of it is actually associated with disease. We call that pathogenic bacteria, and the other ones, the good bacteria, we also call it symbiotic bacteria. So you can use good bacteria or symbiotic or pathogenic bacteria. How I like to think about a gut microbiome is like a bunch of different bacteria kind of competing. The good bacteria sometimes win sometimes, and the bad bacteria other times, but there's this whole relationship. It's not like good or bad. It's this constant transient digestive pathway, and what you eat actually on a daily basis affects it, and your gut microbiome can change completely in 48 to 72 hours. So it's this constant environment that's constantly changing. It's its own ecosystem. It's kind of its like own world that's living inside of you. Your gut microbiome is kind of like a crazy dance party rave. And sometimes the songs are wrong and the vibe is wrong. And we wanna really try to get back that bacteria back into balance, back into that symbiotic effect that we're really, really nourishing our body and flourishing our gut microbiome. It's really important because the more we're studying about gut microbiome, it's a pretty new science, the more we're showing that the pathogenic or bad bacteria really leads to inflammation, can lead to digestive issues, can lead to food intolerances, can lead to cardiovascular disease, can lead to hormone disruptions as well. Hormones are stored in our gut, and it plays a huge role in our gut-brain connection. You've heard people say that your gut is your second brain. Well, it really is true. Our brain and our gut are completely linked from the vagus nerve. It's just one nerve, and they're constantly talking to each other. The story I like to tell people is you felt stressed before, right? Before a first date, or you know, you have a big presentation, and you feel those butterflies in your stomach. Those butterflies in your stomach is actually microbes. Those are actually bacteria from your gut microbiome talking to your brain, and it goes bi-directional. So if you're stressed, it actually talks to our gut and vice versa. And we do a whole other video talking about stress and gut microbiome. So like and follow for more gut health videos. But let's talk about more about our gut microbiome. Our job is try to get more good bacteria and try to lessen the load of that bad bacteria. And there's a lot of environmental factors. As a registered dietitian, I always like to think about food and how we can use prebiotic-rich food and probiotic-rich food to help optimize our gut microbiome and help make those good bacteria flourish. One of the missing pieces in gut health oftentimes is inflammation. So inflammation systemically in our body, think of it as like swelling. Our body doesn't function as well. And in our gut, we actually have something that's called microvilli that helps the absorption capacity of our gut microbiome. They look like fingers. Inflammation or swelling in the gut makes them shrivel up and not work so well. So that can increase the risk of body not absorbing foods, intolerances, bloating, all those symptoms. Some foods increase inflammation in our gut. The more processed foods, ultra processed foods, foods that are high in nitrates, some processed meats, those can all increase gut inflammation and lead us to that more pathogenic pathway instead of like the fruits, vegetables, prebiotics, probiotics that are gonna really heal our gut microbiome. Also, stress management plays a huge role in keeping our gut microbiome healthy and happy because stress actually changes the pH, so the acid-base balance of our gut microbiome, and can accelerate the growth of that bad bacteria that leads to heart disease and other cancers, honestly. Bad bacteria can actually increase our risk of having colon cancer. So let's try to get that gut back into balance. So if you feel like the vibe is off in your gut microbiome dance party, there is so much that you can do to help increase your gut microbiome, to increase those good bacteria and potentially weed out some of that bad bacteria. So if you love this video, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button so you can learn more about how to optimize your gut microbiome in a practical and easy way. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you soon.